wind you well. It's about 5:30 in the morning, and I just woke up. But I went to bed last night around 6 o'clock because I was up the night before watching the news and just processing everything in our world. And I know a lot of us have been talking about it a lot over on Instagram. A lot of you have been messaging me about, like, how to deal with the stress of it all. And hopefully through this blog I talk a little bit about that. But I don't know. I have videos I want to film this weekend, but it feels so odd to film a luxury review or anything. It just feels weird. I'm gonna make some coffee, turn on the fireplace, and avoid the TV. That's the first step I'm going to take. I'm going to avoid the TV. I am going to read the news this morning in the paper, but just gonna kind of like disconnect, and then I'm gonna head off to the gym and just work out some stress. So, time to get coffee, time to get the fireplace going. So, one thing I've been doing is been treating myself with some coffee, and instead of regular sugar, I've been using a little bit of brown sugar. I only do this about once or twice a week, but I didn't eat dinner last night, so I have no guilt in adding a little bit extra to my coffee, and then just some unsweetened almond milk.
You've reached Rich and Gloria. Leave your number and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hey Mama, it's me. I thought I'd give you a call real quick. It has been a crazy week, so I'm sorry I haven't been able to get back to you. But I'm doing really well. Just finished up at the gym and now I'm going to get a haircut. I will try calling you after my haircut. But I love you bunches, and tell Dad I love him, and I will talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
Hey.
Hey, Mama.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
I tried calling this morning.
Yeah, I must have had Lacey out.
Oh, okay. I just finished up my haircut.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, it was desperately needed. I've had, like, this week has been insane. Like,
yeah,
so busy, ridiculously busy. I've been, like, 900 meetings because, like, we're all gearing up for, like, next year. And
there's, yeah,
like, trying to hire for next year. It's just been crazy.
Good grief. That time again.
That is a way to enter your car with that music playing. I have filmed how I organize all of my planner belongings. So I have that video filmed. I just need to edit it. And I knew I was going to vlog today, but I've just been like in a weird filming state of mind. It just feels really bizarre to me to talk about skincare or planning an organization. It just feels contrived when there's so much going on in the world. And so many of you have been asking me, like, how do you deal with this stress? I will tell you, this morning, I made it like a really clear point to not watch the news. I read it briefly on my iPad and then I put it away. And I really focused this morning on just creating like a very peaceful, reflective environment. So I meditated. I made a really good cup of coffee. I put on the fireplace, and then I simply pulled Anne of Green Gables because I have my grandmother's copy, the copy which we read on her front porch, and I just started to read that today. Even though I've literally read that book at least 25 times, That's not an exaggeration. I've literally read it at least 25 times. I just felt that I needed something comforting, and that is really comforting to me. And then I went to the gym and I worked out really, really hard. And now what always relaxes me is doing a little bit of organization and cleaning. So I'm actually going to the dollar store to get a bunch of bins so that I can go through all of my skincare, all of my bathroom junk, and really get rid of some things and toss some stuff away that, like, I don't know why I still have, because it's stuff that didn't work for me, and I just need to get rid of it. So I'm going to do that today and just, like, thin down everything. And I forgot my wallet. So I'm actually going to turn my car around and go right back home, because that's what it did. Because I'm cool. A couple of you live in Stockholm, and I know you guys had a tragedy yesterday. I'm so grateful that you're just safe, and I just hope that everyone stays safe and squeezes their loved ones a little bit more. And I think the best thing we can do in situations like this is, like, love more and do more for others. And with that, hopefully it starts to create some change. These moments like this, I just can't understand. I just can't understand it. Why we just can't love and be kind. It makes your life so much easier. I just, for the life of me, I will never ever get it. And thanks to Elizabeth, because she said, "Are you filming today? I miss a video from you." And I was like, yeah, I'm filming. And then her response to me was like, "The positivity you bring and the joy you bring is how you uplift people's spirits in times like these." And the fact that that resonates so strongly with everyone, just, I don't know, I cannot wrap my mind around it. And all of you are sharing the channel, which I think is the huge testament to why we're growing. I just appreciate it so much. And then, oh my gosh, I have to tell you guys this. On Instagram, one of our Instagram family members and one of our YouTube family members, Crystal, sent me a picture of her son and her watching one of my videos, and it literally made me smile so big it, like, hurt my face. I am so happy that I make content that, like, you never have to worry about your child watching, because I'm never going to swear, I'm never going to act foolish or anything like that. And just the fact that she's sharing that with her son, oh my gosh, my whole heart lit up with joy. Like, I'm going to get teary-eyed and weird just thinking about it right now, because it's just so cool to me. All right, we are back at home. I'm gonna go grab my wallet. And you guys know which one that is. And that's the Volvo telling me I'm too close. I thought I put it in park and I didn't. I don't know if you would have been able to sense that, but I literally could have ran into the wall of the garage. I'll be right back. I think you guys are going to be really surprised by the planner haul video, because something has gotten into me and I have now bought 3 planners that are not Louis Vuitton. And I'm telling you what, I really love them. I really love them. I will always go back to Louis Vuitton, but I think it's because I've been using that planner. I've been using the Desk Agenda, the MM, the GM, the PM for literally 5 years, maybe even longer. No, about 5 years. And I think it's just having something fresh and new that I am loving so much. So I'm excited to share those with you in the planner haul video, because I have 2 new ones, and that's what I'm waiting for. I'm waiting for the last one to arrive, but I got new inserts, new dividers, some new stickers, some new pens to show all of you, and I'm really excited about it. And then, of course, I'll review them and do some Plan With Me videos with these new things. But I hope you guys really like it. All right, we have wallet in hand. A lot of you are asking for new music recommendations. I actually pre-ordered a new album, so I only have a couple songs off of it so far, but I am really, really loving it, and it's by the artist Ruth B, and the album is called Superhaven. If you like Frances, she has a very similar vibe. I'm gonna play you a little snippet of it.
You're really cute, I must admit, but I need something deeper than this. I wanna know when I'm looking at you that you don't only see the things you want to. 'Cause I'm not perfect, I'm flawed, and if you don't like that, get lost. 'Cause I don't want it if it's fake, I don't want it if it's just for show. It's been a long day and I'm trying to figure it out. The way those words left your mouth.
Also, I know that you guys want me to take you into stores. I have no problem with that. My dollar store isn't that special. I'm actually just going to grab some bins, so I'm not going to take you in, but I will definitely do that more in the future so you can really, really shop with me. But for now, I'm just going to hop on over. Anytime I'm at the dollar store, that is one place I always do a random act of kindness because, A, it's super simple to do, and it costs not very much. So behind me was an older lady, and she had a bunch of cards and some gift bags and some like odds and ends. And as I was going through, I said, I'm going to go ahead and pay for the lady behind me. And she's like, oh my goodness, no. And I was like, absolutely. So I went ahead and let the cashier bring up her stuff, and I paid for it as well. And the look on her face was so lovely. And then we walked out to the parking lot together, and we just chatted about the weather, and I wished her like a really great day, and she wished me a really great day, and it was just a really cool moment. And it helps you remember what's important in life. I am now going to run home and let you kind of go through the sort with me of all the products that I need to get rid of. And I will warn you before we get home that my life is very, very organized. Steven will tell you I am a neat freak and keep everything very organized. The one area of my life that is not organized is my bathroom cabinet under my sink, and also my drawer where I keep all my skincare. It is the farthest thing from organized, so I'm excited to like pare stuff down, get rid of things that I don't use or don't like, and then kind of just have the things that I really enjoy. I literally will probably have stuff that is a few years old that we need to get rid of. And you will probably laugh because you will realize how old some of this stuff is. Other random acts of kindness that I do often, I will always, at like the drive-thru at Starbucks or Dunkin' Donuts, I will pay for the person behind me. I do that almost every time I go. I have only had one really bad experience with doing that, where I ended up paying for someone who was ordering for like their entire office, and the bill was pretty outrageous. That was like one of my funny moments with it, but that's only happened one time. The other thing I'll do often as well is when I'm cashing out at the grocery store, I've done this at Target as well, I'll buy like a $25 gift card, and then I will give it to someone who's randomly entering the store. I really enjoy doing that one. I do that one around the holidays a lot. Especially at the grocery store. It's a fun one. Also, other great random acts of kindness is I love to just write people notes and cards all the time. I also have like a random act of kindness with my one neighbor, who is the most lovely person on here. She'll sometimes leave comments on my Instagram, so look out for her. She's like truly one of the best people, and they have one of the most amazing daughters in the planet, and we have done this fun game of just like putting things in their mailbox, or in the spring and summer when we're always outside, like I'll just pick stuff up and find them outside and go take little gifts. Other things I love to do is just strike up conversation. Like, people don't consider that an act of kindness, but like just strike up a conversation and don't tell them anything about you. Just ask them tons of questions about themselves and their day. you never know how much that can impact someone. That's my Volvo beeping, but I wasn't even close to anything. I don't know why it beeped at me. Also, some of you asked about my outdoor space, and I'm actually going to give you a sneak peek at that. We are going to start putting things out tomorrow because it's supposed to be really nice. I have a tip for you about outdoor furniture and when you're getting it out for the year. And you know, the worst job on the planet during that routine is scrubbing down your cushions. I have a go-to recipe that I got from my mom for cleaning your outdoor cushions, and it works every single time. In a bucket, I don't have exact measurements, I just do it by eyeball. You want to add some borax and some dish detergent and hot water. You want to scrub it with like a sponge or a scrub brush. I use a scrub brush because I like to really get into the fibers and clean them. And then just let them sit out in the sun for about like 15-20 minutes. And then just hose them off, sit them on an edge to dry. And that is like the best way to clean your cushions. I feel like a 1950s housewife talking about borax. Many of you have asked me about setting up a P.O. box, and I finally did do that. I know a couple of you want to send me planner stickers that you make that you want me to give out a try, and I will be more than happy to. But yeah, I finally set up the P.O. box. Part of my love is like handwritten cards and notes. So if something comes to that P.O. box, you better believe I'm doing a handwritten card or note back to you, because I love written correspondence. My grandmother and I, from the time I moved away from our hometown, we always handwrote letters back and forth to each other, even though we talked on the phone constantly. There's something about a handwritten note or card that just, like, I think is the best thing ever. Alrighty, it is time to throw on some comfy clothes, some good music, and start cleaning out my skincare drawers. And we're gonna get rid of some foolishness. Ready? All right, gang, I am in my bathroom. I have my bins from the dollar store, and I'm about to be really vulnerable and show you that I'm really not as organized. This is literally, Stephen will tell you, the one place in the home that I cannot rein in, and that is my skincare drawer. So get ready for this, because it is a tragic mess. So, it looks worse when you look on the camera, I promise. It is simply a full-blown disaster, and there is stuff in there that I don't need. So we're gonna go through it. I'm gonna put on some good music, and we're just going to clean it out. A Crabtree and Evelyn. Hold up. I didn't even know I had this from Lush. I think this is one of those bubble bars that I never ever use. I also, for some reason, like, always keep packaging from things, like from the Sunday Riley, like, seriously? Oh my goodness, I bought these fragrances like so long ago. They're by Demeter. This one's supposed to smell like a bonfire. And it does, it has like a smoky scent. You can layer them. So you can have like a bonfire and grass. That one really does smell like freshly cut grass. I bought these, and based on the price, I thought I was getting like this small bottle, and it's actually enormous. And then I feel like I have two more from Demeter. Peach. That one smells good. And lastly, one I'm gonna smell like a floozy when this is all said and done. I really do like that one, the beeswax. Now, this is appalling. I don't know if you guys remember when Bethany Frankel came out with her skincare line. I like went crazy and bought literally everything. I've never ever used it. And I'm probably, well, would it even stay good? I literally like have every product from the Bethany Frankel product line. I have like masks and body washes and moisturizers, and I never liked it. And that's probably why it hasn't been made. But for some reason, I've been holding on to it for 4 years, like all of a sudden it's gonna make a comeback. So that's got to go, because I don't touch the stuff. I mean, some of it is still sealed in the plastic, like a kiwi scrub. I don't want to smell like a kiwi. Smoothing, firming body lotion? No thank you. So, my battery is dying, but now that I've cleaned out my drawer, I thought I'd share with you a couple new things that I picked up, some today and some that came this week. First of all, I got this new travel cosmetic bag. It has like elastic in it, so you can stick brushes and bottles in there, and then it just cinches. And it is from the company Casper and Cole, and I will leave them linked down below, but I got some really great products from them. So I'm gonna share three products, and it is called Whipped Soap, and I actually used one today after the gym. One is mango and papaya, and what it is it's just a soap, but it is super light and super fluffy, and it smells really, really great. So I got mango and papaya. I also got strawberry. This is the one I used this morning. I loved it. It foamed up really well, and I only actually needed to use a little bit. And then the other one I got was beach. This is the one I was kind of disappointed with because I haven't even used it. And as you can see, like, it's empty. I don't know if like the whip didn't work, but I'm kind of disappointed with this one. So this all came from Casper and Cole, but the company that makes this whip soap is called Seven Chakras Soap Company. But I was really happy with the strawberry one this morning, but the beach one just didn't come packaged as well, and it looks deflated, or it just didn't get filled up. The next thing is I picked up a bunch of products from Glossier recently. I got that really cool sweatshirt. It is the most comfortable sweatshirt on the planet. But I got a tinted moisturizer in the color Light. This is kind of like a less expensive version of my Biteric. It doesn't give you coverage, but it just simply like gives your skin a nice tint. It does correct some like really small light blemishes, but I enjoyed this. Then next I got the two stretch concealers because I've heard these highly recommended for dark circles. And I got it in two shades. So I got it light for right now, and then I also got it in medium for the summer because my face will get really tan and my hair will get really, really blonde. So I got it in two shades, just so I know I'm covered. And then quickly becoming one of my favorite lip balms is the GlossierBalm.com, and I got it in rose and I got it in coconut. Both are not tinted in any way. It's just like the fragrance and the scent. Also picked up the blonde Boy Brow, and it is just like really small blonde for my eyebrows. I haven't used it yet, but I'm excited to. I've been trying to fill in my brows. By the way, I talked to you guys on Instagram about microblading. I have an appointment with like the best lady in the city, but she's so great that I cannot get in till June. So I have an appointment. I'm gonna take you guys with me, and you guys will get to experience all that fun stuff with me. And then lastly, today I have finally bit the bullet. It like tore out my heart and soul to spend this much on skincare, but I did it. And I bought the La Mer soft cream. Olga, my skincare lady, had been giving me samples of this and I loved it, but I can never bring myself to buy it. I'm gonna be honest with you, it is insanely expensive. This is the small jar. It was $170. And like the large jar, she was like, oh, the large jar is $320. I was like, I'll take the small one. So this was quite the splurge. And then I've also heard really great things about their lip balm. So I picked up the La Mer lip balm as well. I'm just gonna build my La Mer collection every time I go get my hair cut, because where I buy all my skincare and most of my fragrances is also in the same exact location. So I'll just buy one piece each 4 weeks when I go for my haircut. But now I'm gonna give you a glimpse to my drawer because it looks immensely better. So now look at it. I got rid of so much stuff, and then I just used all my dollar store bins and I organized it as such. This is all a bunch of masks. This is moisturizers.
brushes, cleansers, and then lastly, sun care, hair care, all of that jazz. So now it is all nice and neat and taken care of. So I got rid of a lot of stuff, but now I need to tackle my shelf because I was able to take some things from my shelf down into my drawer and I just need to tidy up that area. Steven absolutely hates this side of the bathroom, but such is life. And now you can see I have organized all of my shelf. Here you can see like some of my like go-to products that are like always on hand. Thank you. I forget who recommended it. The SJP Stash and the Elizabeth and James Bourbon. I've been wearing them layered together. And oh my goodness, it is the best thing ever. And it was a recommendation from one of you. And I'm obsessed with it. Alrighty, gang. So we finished up dinner. Steven took Bubba's for a really quick walk around the neighborhood. And we're just going to spend the night in and watch a movie on Netflix or on Apple TV. And I've poured a glass of wine to relax. And I actually think picking up this camera today has made me feel a little bit better. But I'm going to end this vlog because it's already really long. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave a comment down below if you made it this far because I appreciate you. But I will leave this vlog like I leave all of them. Take care of yourself, take care of others, and be kind. In this world, we need to give more kindness. And it's free, so give it to everyone. Until next time, bye-bye.